guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm so glad you stopped by today because today we are finally going to work on that one skeleton creature that I had to put off because of some weird ordering issue. I know a lot of you guys still wanted to see it even though it's not Halloween anymore, so I decided to order the fabric from another buyer that I like better because I've never had issues with them. And today we are going to be making it. Today I'm going to be making a Cobra skeleton plushie. It's going to be all plush except for a little wire that's going to run through it to make it posable. Anyways, let's get started. Okay, since this piece does not have any clay pieces or anything like that, we don't have to worry about sculpting or painting or anything, so we're just going to be working on sewing and putting everything together. So the first thing that I'm going to work on for our Cobra is going to be the skull. So I'm going to show you the patterns for it, and then we're going to put it all together. Now this is going to look a little bit complicated, but it honestly isn't that bad. Just imagine putting a box together. You need a piece for each side. So in the middle right here, I have the top of the skull. This is going to also be used to make the bottom of the skull. And then over here is the side of the skull. So this is going to be used to make the left and the right. I already have the little patterns drawn out to make the skull patterns, but we're not going to get to that just yet. And then up here is going to be the very back of the skull where it's going to connect to the spine of the cobra. So I'm going to use my pattern pieces and get all my fabric cut out, and then I'm going to show you guys how to put it together. Now when cutting out my fabric, I decided that it was going to be easier to have the top, bottom, and the back of the skull all connected. So I basically just kind of put them together on the fabric, traced around those, and then cut them out. So it's going to be one solid piece now. And then the only other pieces that you're going to need are going to be the left and right of the skull. Now I have this cut out in black, but I also need to cut it out in either a white or a cream color. I'm using kind of a creamy color because I don't want it to be exactly white. I want it to look a little bit more like a bone. So again, you're going to be using your pattern to cut out two different versions of the skull. You're going to have a black version and a cream color version. And the reason for this is you're going to actually layer these fabrics. That way you can create the illusion of a skull. So we're going to go back to our pattern right now. Remember how I had the skull pattern already drawn out onto the basic shape of our skull? Well, we're going to start cutting that out and we're going to trace it onto the black fabric version of our pattern. So I'm just going to cut the extra paper off of this and then I'm going to lay it out on the fabric and I'm going to trace around it. And then after you have everything traced onto the black fabric, we're going to pin the black fabric pieces to the cream colored pieces. As you can see, I have everything drawn out and they're all pinned together, and now we're going to be using our sewing machine. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to use our sewing machine and we're going to follow all the lines that we traced onto our black fabric and use that to connect the two pieces of fabric together. So we're basically sewing the cream colored fabric on top of the black colored fabric. Now this part takes a little bit of time and you do want to be careful because you want to follow the lines as precise as you can. So you're going to be kind of going a little bit slower with your sewing machine than if you were just to zip through a straight line. I actually really enjoy doing this. The sewing not so much because it is really tedious, but I really enjoy cutting off the extra fabric, which is what we're going to do after we have all of our lines sewn. Okay, like I said, all of our lines are sewn, and now we're going to take our scissors and we're going to cut off all the extra cream colored fabric, exposing the black color fabric in the holes of the skull. So it's going to look like a skull a little bit more once we have all this extra fabric removed. Okay, I've removed all the excess fabric and you can really start seeing the skull take shape right now. Now we just need to put all of our pieces together. Now this part is a little bit tricky to show on camera, but basically what we're going to be doing is that large piece of the skull, the part that is the back, the top, and the bottom, we're going to be taking that and we're going to sew it around the side of the skull, connecting everything together. So we're going to do that to one side and then we're going to do the same thing to the other side. Now to make things a lot easier, what I did was I just sewed everything inside out, and then I cut a little slit at the very bottom of the chin, kind of where the black is, so it's easier to hide a seam, and I'm just going to flip it right side out, and we're going to stuff it. Okay, so that's basically our skull. Now we're going to move on to making the ribs and the spine of the snake. Now because I want this to kind of look like a cobra, I want the ribs to be a lot larger around the frill of the neck, which is still obviously the spine. There's really no neck or spine difference, it's just we're going to kind of try and distinguish the two.
So this portion of the skeleton is going to be connected directly to the skull, and we're just going to call it the neck right now. Now this portion of the skeleton I have broken into two different pieces, mainly because I didn't have larger paper and it was just easier to draw it out this way. But when I cut it out on the fabric, I'm going to actually combine these two and just make it one solid piece of fabric. And then after the neck portion of the skeleton, we're going to make the rest of the spine. So this is going to be very simple. I have just a small portion of it drawn out and cut out, and we're going to be tracing this on our fabric and just making a very long piece. So we don't have to cut the fabric out into smaller portions like this. We can make one long strip of fabric. And then to finish it off, I just had a little bit of a rounded off point for the very end of the tail. So I'm going to use these pattern pieces and I'm going to cut everything out, and then I'm going to show you guys the sewing for it. Okay, so these are the portions I have right now. I don't have them completely cut out because we are going to be doing a little bit of sewing before we continue sewing everything together. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to switch out the white thread that I have in my sewing machine with a black, and we're going to kind of make lines separating the vertebra of the spine. So basically, I already have it drawn out on the pattern, and I'm just going to be sewing down these lines all the way through the pattern. I'm going to be doing the same thing on the neck portion, the spine portion, and then the very tip of the tail. This part can take quite a bit of time. Honestly, all these steps could take quite a bit of time depending on how large and how long you want your snake to be. After we have all those lines sewn to separate the vertebra, we can now move on to sewing the bones together. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the bottom and the top portion of our bones, we're going to sandwich them together with the fuzzy part on the inside, we're going to pin those together, and then we're going to sew along those lines that we have drawn out on the fabric. Now before I started sewing this, I did switch from the black thread back to my white thread in the sewing machine. That way none of my stitches really show up too much. So I'm going to do this to the neck portion of the skeleton, the spine portion, and the tip of the tail. After I'm done with this sewing, I'm going to use my scissors to cut off all the extra fabric in between each rib portion and stuff like that. I'm just removing everything that we don't need. So now after we have all that sewn and all the extra fabric removed, we need to start flipping everything right side out. Since a lot of this is really thin and stuff, you'll probably need to use a wooden dowel to help you get all the different things flipped out. And then once you have everything flipped right side out, we're going to start stuffing our bones. Now you'll probably need to use that wooden dowel that you use to flip everything right side out to get the stuffing in, because everything is really thin and it's really hard to get stuffing kind of in all these little thin cracks without just using something a lot longer than your fingers. Okay, all of our bone pieces are all finished, and now the last thing we need to do is put them together. So the order you're going to put them together is going to be skull, neck, spine, and then the very tip of the tail is at the very end. And I'm just going to do this by hand. I'm not going to use my sewing machine or anything like that. I'm just going to use a needle and thread.
Made a cobra skeleton plush. I had so much fun making him. I hope we can do more bone creatures like this maybe in the future. Maybe we can do dinosaurs so we can have them fossil themed or something. Let me know what you guys want to see. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to like, subscribe, do all that fun stuff, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!